Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to WDSU-TV's continuing coverage of Delaware State University Hornet basketball. This is game two of our doubleheader as your Delaware State University men's basketball team will look to get a win as the women did earlier against NJIT here today at Memorial Hall Gym. Once again, my name is Byron Dixon. I'm joined alongside my broadcast partner, Roland DeVries. The Delaware State University men will look to get a win here today. They're taking a break from conference play. They welcome for the first time here to Memorial Hall, NJIT, New Jersey Institute of Technology. I'm now going to toss it over to my broadcast partner, Roland DeVries. Roland, what are your keys to the game as the players that you're looking forward to watching today?
Well, you know, the Highlanders come into this matchup with a record of 8-13. It's the first time that the Hornets have seen the Highlanders come in here. So I think it's going to be a new situation for both these teams as they meet for the very first time. Now, the Hornets carry in a record of 4-14. And what they're going to look to try to do here early on is control the tempo. The Hornets are a team that wants to slow the ball down. They want to move into their half-court offenses and take a deliberate approach to playing basketball here against the Highlanders. Now, on the other hand, the Highlanders are going to want to speed it up with a big man that they've got at Damon Lynn, and we'll get further into that later on. The other thing that they're going to want to do is stay out of foul trouble. They don't want to find themselves putting the Highlanders on the line early or often. So it's going to be imperative that they sit there and play good sound basketball from the get-go. Another thing is bench production. We saw a few weeks back where Norfolk State came in and the Hornets played a very, very sound game against Norfolk State where they got great contributions from their bench. And that's exactly what they need against the Highlanders there this evening. Again, this is a non-conference game, but it's very important for the Hornets to get out on a winning track as they try to right their ship and try to salvage something out of this season.
Thanks, Byron. Let's go to the starters here, ladies and gentlemen, as we're getting ready for tip-off for NJIT. You have Kai Howard. You have Damon Lynn, one of our players to watch. Terrence Smith. Odira Enrique, Manny Salentikas. And for Delaware State University, the men's Hornets, you have Casey Walker, Tyshawn Bell, Kendall Gray, AJ Thomas, and Charles Burley as your probable starters for this evening. We're just about ready to do the intros here, ladies and gentlemen, for our starters. Definitely looking forward to this game, Roland. See what the men can do to get out to a good, fast start and try to get a home win.
Yeah, it's going to be important for the Hornets to do that. But one thing they're going to have to do is they're going to have to shut down a young guy named Damon Lynn for the Highlanders. He's a freshman guard. His last game out, wow, he poured in 34 points, fired 9 three-pointers, and set NJIT Division I records against North Carolina A&T on the 18th of January. So they're going to have their hands full trying to watch that guy this afternoon.
We're getting some recognitions here before the game. You got Kendall Gray, MEAC Player of the Week, and you have Casey Walker as Player of the Week. So it's good to see those recognized in front of the hometown fans here for their great play. They've had great spurts this season. You just hope they can all put it together at the right time as we get closer to MEAC tournament time.
And that is huge, Byron, is you said it, all playing together. And that's where their difficulty has been this year, is that you get one guy playing well or two guys playing well, and the other three are non-existent on the floor. They need a full team concentrated effort to be able to sit there and pull this win out tonight against the Highlanders.
Definitely. We definitely want to see, like I said, what the bench can do as well today possibly. We saw Coach Jackson go to them a few games ago against Norfolk State, and you want to see if he can keep that up. Guys like Nick Doyle and Madron, and see if they can help out with some of these starters when they're struggling and go from there. Looks like Madron Gasevich is starting today. And Nick Doyle will start again today. AJ Thomas is starting today. Kendall Williams is starting today. And Kendall Gray is starting today, ladies and gentlemen. So a little bit of a shakeup there. I didn't see that coming.
I know it's not baseball, but they threw us a curve on that one, starting Nick Doyle and Myron Gasevich this evening. That was not what we expected coming out. So Tyshawn Bell doesn't get the start, and neither does Casey Walker. Is that correct?
Yes.
So Tyshawn Bell, Casey Walker coming
off
the bench.
So Tyshawn Bell and Casey Walker will be coming off the bench. So that'll be interesting to see. So we're just about ready for tip-off. It'll be interesting to see how this new five coexists together. And the tip is off. It goes to NJIT. Winfield Willis with the ball. Shot is blocked partially, looks like. Rebounded by Kendall Gray. Thomas will bring the ball up court. Out to Kendall Williams. Now, Dole State will set up their motion offense that they like to run under Coach Jackson. We're scoreless here, just about 30 seconds into the game. See Kendall Gray on the post calling for the ball. Thomas will give it to Nick Doyle with the pull-up jump shot. Shot is off.
Well, Doyle had a good look. He just didn't put it in there. They're quick on a transition with the Highlanders.
Shot is missed by Damon Lynn. And they will give it back out to Dell State. Gives it to Kendall. Kendall with the lay-in. And the Hornets are on the board and have broken the scoring seal.
Virgin Gasevich had a good look, and that was a tough pass into Kendall Gray, but Gray caught it and made a good conversion up underneath the bucket.
You see a little bit of the European style of play over there, overseas, from Serbia. The finesse play, playing at the high post, able to pass from that position, as well as look to score if the opportunity presents itself. So a little culture shot there.
And the big man is pretty nimble on his feet and with the ball. So not a bad play by Gasevich right there at the top of the key.
Three-pointer no good by Willis. Thomas with the rebound. Brings the ball past half court. Doyle gives it to Gray. Out to Williams. Our impact players on the board. Kendall Williams with the jump shot.
Well, the Highlanders collapsed low at Kendall Gray as he was down. He just turned, spotted Williams, and Williams knocked it down for 15 feet out. If Williams stays open and can hit, man, that could be a great night for him.
Shot is no good there by Terrence Smith. Thomas will give it to Williams. Madron in the post. The drop step, power dribble. Looks like he was a little out of control there and falls out of bounds, creating a turnover.
Yeah, he caught himself in a bad position down there. Got triple teamed, tried to force the issue, and costly turnover. Something that we don't want to have for Delaware State tonight.
You see Coach Jackson tell him, pass the ball in that situation.
But I like this lineup so far. It's going to build some confidence for both Doyle and Gasevich out there to let them know that the coach has got a lot of trust in them to deliver. They just need to do it.
It'll be a travel call.
Unforced error there by the Highlanders. We saw that earlier with the ladies, with Kersey taking her steps before she put the ball on the court.
Doyle has the ball on the left wing. Out to Kendall Gray, who will set the screen for A.J. Thomas. Thomas doesn't take the screen. Now he does. Gives it out to Williams. Out to Doyle. Madron is in the post again. Doyle is, looks like it'll be a foul called. Looks like he was stripped there, but is a foul called on.
I like the way Doyle tried to force the issue against the Highlanders. Make them make a either pass or take the shot. He was ready to take the shot when he lost the ball.
Gray with the jump hook over the left shoulder. Shot is good. It looks like NJIT wants to talk things over, but Kendall Gray's come out aggressive. That MEAC Player of the Week Award is motivating him. You look at the drop step, the left hand, the right-handed hook over the left shoulder, a la LaMarcus Aldridge. So you see he's been in the gym working on that post game a little bit.
I like it. Get the ball down to the big man. Make the Highlanders collapse onto him. So far we've seen him convert his two field goals, or if he hasn't had a shot, he's kicked it out to where Kendall Williams has been able to convert for there. So far the offense has looked pretty good so for the Hornets.
Somebody like Kendall Gray, well, you know he has a distinct size advantage against a team like NJIT. You tell the coach, send a limo for the team, pick those big guys up. You want them at the game early and often to take advantage of those guys.
Exactly.
Kai Howard will bring the ball up court. Howard will receive the pass from Tim Coleman. Pass is stolen partially, but given right back. Shot is no good there by Damon Lynn. It'll be a jump ball, looks like. Hornet basketball.
Good hustle by the Hornets on defense there. Gasevich almost had a turnover earlier on, but he just couldn't maintain control over it. But they got the ball loose and was able to turn it into a jump ball with a possession going to the Hornets.
Good to see multiple guys diving on the floor doing the little things that make a big impact.
And that's huge too, Byron, the little things. And a lot of people don't realize that when they're watching the game of basketball. It's those little things that make the big things better. It's how you win.
Shot is up and off. Fighting for the rebound is Thomas. Looks like it'll be.
They're going to get Thomas for going over the back.
All right. Looks like a timeout. So, Roland, what are you very fascinated at so far within the first 5 minutes of this game?
Well, I like the idea that they're trying to get Kendall Gray hot down low, which he is so far. I also like the idea that Nick Doyle is taking some shots. What I don't like is that he hasn't been able to make them. So I think it's really important that Nick Doyle be able to heat up from the outside, which will keep the Highlanders honest. If they know that all they have to do is try to defend Gray down low in the post, well, eventually they'll be able to work him down or wear him down. So right now the offense looks pretty good. We just need some outside shots to go down to keep the Highlanders honest.
I like with Kendall Gray and Kendall Williams, our impact player, they have come out aggressive. Even Nick Doyle, he hasn't made a shot yet, but he's getting some good looks, and you hope to think some of those will fall. And Madron Gasevich, he's doing the little things, hustling, making impact, altering shots. So it'll be interesting to see how that plays out through the rest of this game.
Well, another thing this does, starting Gasevich and Nick Doyle, is that it doesn't wear down Tyshawn Bell and Casey Walker later on in the game. So you're actually saving your team for later on so that these players are going to be well-rested later in the game.
Kendall Gray with 4 points, 2 rebounds, and Kendall Williams with 2 points for all of the Delaware State scoring, but it's been working too so far. It's the Kendall show. Del State come out in a little bit of a trapping defense here.
Yeah, right now the Highlanders are 0 for 5 on the field. Of course, the score indicates that as well.
Pass, drive. Looks like a travel will be called. Too many steps there by Tim Coleman, the freshman.
Good defense to sit there and force him into a shot he really didn't want to take.
Gray, looks like an offensive foul will be called. Got in the air and didn't know what to do and tried to pass the ball. Offensive foul.
Yeah, Tim Coleman had position down low and Gray just turned and just rammed right into him. Sometimes I'm not too sure about some of those passes when you're trying to get the big men while they're in motion. It just leaves them in a bad position when they try to convert their shots.
Three-pointer is good. Tim Coleman. He will get the NJIT Knights on the board. Highlanders, I'm sorry. We'll get them on the board. They broke the scoring seal.
Yeah, Coleman was open at the top of the key, and he didn't waste any time and buried it to give them their first three of the day.
Gray draws the foul. Got to feed him early and often in this matchup. No one can really compare to him in size on the court for NJIT, so got to take advantage of that mismatch.
And Gosevich has been able to find it. The big two telephone poles are able to look at each other quite easily.
Great to the line. Free throw is good. Second free throw is no good for Gray. I'm sorry. Coleman. Shot is good by Jake Duncan, the southpaw freshman from Williamsburg, Virginia. Comes in, knocks down the corner three, and NJIT trails by one. 14 minutes remaining in the first half.
Well, Duncan came off the bench in their previous game and nailed 20 off on the bench, so the young man can fire it in.
Obi Dusty's ball, they'll inbound under the basket. Thomas to Doyle. Three-pointer is good.
Kendall Williams. Three.
Give him three, ladies and gentlemen. Jump shot's no good by Duncan.
That was a nice shot by Williams on the previous run up there. Wide open for the three and nailed it with 5 seconds left on the shot clock.
He's heating up, folks. Look out, our impact player, Kendall Williams, ladies and gentlemen.
That's who we were talking about earlier on. Kendall Williams averaging 8.9 points a game this season, and it's important for him to take that pressure off the big guys.
Coleman for three, shot no good. Rebounded by Kendall Gray.
Casey Walker and Tyshawn Bell getting ready to check in over there. Byron.
Tyshawn Bell, like Casey Walker, Charles Burley.
Out of bounds, still Hornets ball. Hornets substitution, Casey Walker, Charles Burley, and Tyshawn Bell for A.J. Thomas, Marjon Gasevic, and Nick Doyle.
So Doyle, Gasevic, and Thomas will check out. So now you have pretty kind of similar to the starting five that we're used to in the game.
Well, that starting lineup gave them 7 minutes and 29 seconds. Not too bad. Good showing, 12-6 lead. I like the looks of that lineup.
Burley to Walker. Walker on a drive, no call. Looks like it'll be NJIT basketball.
Yeah, Tyshawn Bell, loose ball underneath, just couldn't come up with it. We got another sub coming in now for Kendall Gray.
Check in for Kendall Gray.
So the only starter still left in there is Kendall Williams.
Pass to Lynn. Lynn will give it off to Mayfield. Mayfield on a drive, pull up jump shots. No good, but the rebound is gathered in by NJIT's Terrence Smith, and it'll be a loose ball foul on Tyshawn Bell, looks like.
Yeah, Charles Burley was late to get over there on the initial shot. Then the ball came out, Tyshawn Bell made a foul on a loose ball.
You don't have to be a college athlete to experience the thrill of the game and the joys of winning with games like Powerball, Mega Million, Keno, and dozens of instant games. The Delaware Lottery offers all kinds of ways to play and win. Stop by your local Delaware Lottery retailer to get in on the action. Delaware Lottery.
The score is 12-6 to your Delaware State University Hornets. Lead NJIT by a score of 12-6. 11 minutes, 46 seconds remaining here in the first half. Like we said before, Jordan Lawson checking in for Kendall Gray. So you have Burley, Williams, Bell, Walker on the floor with Lawson. So it looks like Coach Jackson is going to his bench early and often in this contest.
Yeah, early on, Hornets are shooting 63% from the field to the 20% for the Highlanders. The Highlanders have yet to go to the free throw line. Well, the Hornets are shooting 102 with Kendall Gray.
3-point shot is no good by Damon Lynn.
Out of bounds, still Highlander ball.
Hornets a little slow to that loose ball. Lawson just didn't get over there in time. It stayed on the ground or on the court for a while, but nobody claimed it.
NJIT to rebound. Wide open three-pointer is good from Jake Duncan. Can't leave a shooter like that wide open in the shortest distance to the goal, three-point-wise.
No, they've gotten all their points off the three-point marker, and that makes them 3-for-6, shoot 50% from the three-point arc. Like I said earlier, Jake Duncan is not afraid to take that shot.
Ball will stay here for Del State. 11 minutes remaining here in the first half. 12-9, Del State leading by 3 points. Walker to Burley. Burley gives it to Williams. Swings it to Walker. Walker for three, shot is no good.
Different type of offensive set now with Kendall Gray and Gasevich out of there. They're not trying to work the ball low. Trying to actually take more of a perimeter shot on the offensive side of the house.
Burley will bring the ball past half court and set up the Del State offense. Burley to Walker. Walker into Bell, who has the advantage in the post. Face-up jump shot is no good.
Problem is with that shot, with Bell taking it from 15 feet out, there's no one underneath for an offensive rebound.
It's like a foul call. NJIT Highlanders will keep
two,
the basketball.
Kendall Williams, his first personal team's fourth. Morning substitution.
Kendall Gray will sub back in.
For number two, Kendall Williams.
Kendall for Kendall substitution. Kai Howard, top of the key with the basketball for the Highlanders. Shot is up and in.
DeMond Lynn.
This is not the guy we want heating up for the Highlanders, is DeMond Lynn.
Burley to Walker.
JC
layup is good.
Walker. Timeout, NJIT. 30-second timeout. Please visit the DSU United
Way. Del State leading by three. Go ahead, roll.
Supporting the
ahead, roll.
DSU United Way drive.
I think one thing
student,
we saw early on is that they,
and learn more about
with
the
that
DSU
second team
United
coming
Way
in
Way
here,
group.
They moved to an outside
DSU
perimeter
United
shot
Way
as opposed to trying to work
a
ball loose. I don't think Keith or Coach be Jackson sure liked to see that. He brought Kendall Gray back in there. I expect them to start to work back inside the paint again and try to wear the interior down. On the other hand, the Highlanders are not afraid to take that three-point shot. They're a great three-point shooting team, and so far that's where they've been getting their conversions. DeMond Lynn and Jake Duncan has already knocked them down, so it's going to be important for the Hornets to really maintain that pressure for them on the perimeter.
Looks like Del State comes out in a zone, a trapping zone here. Out to DeMond Lynn. Shot is no good. Rebounded.
That right there is just the Hornets unable to come up with that loose ball on the defensive side of a rebound and then committing a foul to give the ball right back over to the Highlanders.
Pass to Duncan. Duncan to a wide open. And number 15, Terrence Smith will hit to the line after the offensive rebound. He got fouled, almost completed the three-point play, but he'll hit to the line for 2 points.
And Terrence Smith just outworked Kendall Gray and Tyshawn Bell for that rebound. He didn't give up, went up there a couple of times and finally got the foul as he tried to convert the shot. And right now on the defensive rebound side of the house, the Hornets are just getting outworked by a smaller Highlander team.
For number zero, Kai Howard.
Rebounded by Gray. Burley with the ball at the top of the key, gives it to Walker. Walker to Tyshawn Bell. Jordan Lawson in the post. Out to wide open Walker. Floater is no good. But caught and athletically followed by Jordan Lawson.
Yeah, that was a good follow-up by Lawson, who came sprinting in underneath, grabbed the loose ball, and fired it right back in for an easy layup.
Playing a game of taps, following up the shot, and putting it back in the basket. DeMond Lynn with the drive and the finish.
He had a quick step to the basket and he beat both the Hornets to the rim and got an easy layup for his effort.
Bell out to Burley. Walker have lost in the post and Gray in the post. Gray at the high post. They double him immediately. He gives it out to Tyshawn Bell. Burley on the drive. hounding defense there by the Highlanders.
Yeah, Burley just got himself out of control bringing the ball to the rim. He lost his dribble. Next thing you know, he just lost the ball as well.
Looks like a blocker foul will be called, and Tim Coleman will be heading to the line.
Foul number five. Right now, the Highlanders are just a step quicker on the offensive side of the house against the Hornets. They're slow to react, and now they're paying for it with blocking fouls.
And NJIT has cut this deficit down to 2 points. 7 minutes, 39 seconds remaining. Roland, what is standing out to you as Dell State's letting NJIT back in this game?
Their three-point shooting is what's really gotten them heating up. But right now, they just look quicker than the Hornets. They're playing with a quicker step. They're moving the ball closer to the rim at a quicker pace. But another thing, they're outworking them on the defensive side of the rebound. Right now, the Hornets are just getting outworked. Their big men are just getting outworked.
The Dell State men have to go back to Kendall Gray here in the post. It was working for them earlier. You have to stick with what works until the defense can prove they can stop it. So them just going away from him completely is not good. If they're going to double team like they've shown, they have to be he has to be a willing pass and pass it out to guys who are willing to take open jump shots.
And that's what I was hoping they're going to do, is just keep the ball down low to Kendall Gray. I mean, he was open earlier on. Work that ball down into him and let them make him go somewhere else. And right now, they haven't even tried to go back down to Gray.
Coleman's first free throw's no good.
I think one of the biggest things kicking off right now, it's, you know, seven minutes, 40 seconds left. Tyshawn Bell's already on the bench with three personal fouls. Tim Coleman.
Thomas has checked back into the game along with Nick Doyle, both Walker and Gray. Looks like a foul will be called, and that'll be on Daquan Holiday.
Highlander foul number 10, Daquan Holiday, his first personal, team's third.
Doyle gives it to Thomas. Walker gives it back to Thomas to Doyle. Kendall Gray, deep post position, passes to Thomas, extra pass to Walker. No shot taken, though. 7 minutes remaining here in the first half. Doyle, pull-up jumper is no good. Rebounded by Lawson. Almost an and-one there by Lawson. He's just outworking this NJIT defense and got a rebound. He's going to line for two shots.
You know, they got the ball to Kendall Gray. Gray didn't have a shot, so he kicked it out to Walker. Walker was open for the jumper. I don't know why he didn't take that shot. He was there. That was great work by Jordan Lawson down low. As he didn't stop, put the ball up, and got the foul.
First free throw's good for Lawson. Second free throw is no good. Duncan with the ball on the right wing. Oh, DeMond Lynn with the ankle breaker. Casey Walker slipping there. Might have to put some tape on those ankles there.
Well, I hate to say it, Byron, but I missed it. I was looking down here at my stats trying to figure out what happened out there. I heard the crowd woo a little bit.
Well, Mr. Walker almost was on the highlight tape, Mr. DeVries. lost in keeping his dribble, falling down. Doyle on the right wing. Looks like a foul is going to be called down low on, looks like number 22, Odara.
Highlander foul number 22, Odara Anuki.
Nwiki.
Nwiki.
It's a tough one.
Hornet substitution.
Odara Nwiki. I was looking at the pronunciation sheet.
Odara.
Also for Delaware State, number 23,
Odara Nwiki.
For number 30, Jordan Lawson.
Doyle takes the inbound pass. Williams gives it off to Walker. Williams takes the screen. Jason Owens is checking to the game. Doyle with the cut. He is fouled. He will head to the line. Good moving without the ball action there.
Highlander foul number 22.
Crowd still hasn't gotten into this game, Byron. I mean, it's 17 to 15 Hornets. You got close 6 minutes left here in the first half. But it's pretty quiet inside Memorial Hall. It's like the crowd is here, but it's not here. I don't understand it.
Looks like Terrence Smith has checked in as Doyle misses the first free throw.
Highlander substitution, number 2, Tim Coleman. For number 25, Rob Okoroba.
NJIT with the ball here. Mayfield gives it off to Coleman. Lynn, the ball, gives it back to Mayfield. Looks like a travel will be called.
Too many steps, Hornets basketball.
Terrence Smith with too many steps there.
Good tight defense by Craig caused that.
Like he had travel plans on that one. Kendall Gray with top of the key. Sets the screen out for Kendall Williams. Doyle to Walker. Walker in the corner. Pass to Owens. Gray's in the post. They bring a double. He loses the handle. Out to Walker. Shot is no good. Rebounded by Gray. He'll go up. Shot is no good. He gets the other rebound. Foul be called.
Tough sledding down low for Kendall Gray, but he finally gets the foul. He's going to the line. So far, the Hornets have gotten 8 points inside the paint to the Highlanders, too. But I think one of the big things that we're looking at right here, we wanted to make sure that the Hornets could control the tempo. They've done that. There's been zero fast break points delivered over there by the Highlanders. It's playing the Hornets basketball game. They want it slow. They want to be able to play their meticulous offensive game. And so far, it's working.
Good to see Kendall Williams bringing the troops together, talking to them, laying out a game plan. Kendall Gray knocks down the 2 free throws. 4 minutes, 48 seconds remaining here in the first half. 20 to 15 is the score. Delaware State is up by 5. Stolen there by Walker. Will State does state ball.
Hornets basketball.
That's just good hustle there by Casey Walker. Gets the turnover on a steal.
Williams receives the pass from Walker. Owens comes up but doesn't get the ball there. Walker to Williams to Doyle. Walker looking for Gray in the post. Ball is tipped out to Doyle. 4-3. Shot is off. No good. Rebounded by NJIC.
But I like that sequence. They tried to get the ball down to Gray, which they did. He didn't have a shot, kicked it out. Nick Doyle just didn't knock down the jumper. So I like the offensive sequence, though.
Jason Owens battling for the rebound there. He will get rewarded on the other end with the shot. And it is good.
Jason Owens.
It's a nice, smooth-looking shot from Walker right there at the top of the key. Nice sweeping arc on that jumper. Nothing but net.
Three-pointer is no good. Skying in for the rebound is Kendall Gray. Three-pointer no good by Montana Mayfield. Doyle to Gray. Shot is blocked. Very red as you see Kendall Gray getting the shot blocked, big as he is.
Traveling violation, Highlander ball. Media timeout.
Yeah, we're seeing the tide slowly turn in the Hornets' way. The Highlanders are shooting 31% so far here in the first half with 3 minutes and 20 seconds left. Kendall Gray had a shot block. Like you said, Byron, it's rare that you're going to see that happen. Then he turns the ball over as well. They could have moved up by about 9 points getting late here in the first half.
3 minutes, 19 seconds remaining here in the first half. 22-15. NJIT Highland is coming to this game 8-13, while the Delaware State University men come in 4-14, 0-6 in the MEAC. Looking at the stats here, Kendall Gray and Kendall Williams both with 7 points. Jordan Lawson with 3 points. Casey Walker and Jason Owens with 2 points. Back play has resumed. It's like a...
out of bounds. Hornets
looks like he stepped out of bounds. Tim Coleman.
Highlander substitution number 0, Kai Howard. For number 14, Montana Mayfield.
Williams to bring the ball past half court. Williams to Doyle. Doyle's pass is deflected.
Still Hornets ball.
Yeah, he was trying to get that ball into Casey Walker and just a little bit too low. Couldn't get it through all that traffic.
Williams receives the ball in the backcourt. Williams gives it to Owens. Owens to Walker. Pass almost stolen, but still lost out of bounds. Walker inbounds to Doyle.
Jason Owens just trying to force it down there to Casey Walker, and it just wasn't enough room.
Doyle. The pull-up jump shot.
Well, Doyle's 1-for-5 from the floor, and it's important to get him hot.
Rebounded by Owens. Owens has given him good, solid minutes off the bench today.
Well, DeMond Lynn's 2-for-9 from the field, so that's good news for the Hornets.
Doyle... Gray to Doyle. Shot is good.
Well, Gray kept feeding to Doyle, and Doyle back to Gray.
And right back at him is Jake Duncan. You have two shooters on the court.
And that's Duncan's third three-pointer. He's got 9 points.
If you're the defense, you got to get back and close out on that shooter.
Yeah, you can't leave Duncan wide open. He leads right now the Highlanders in points with 9.
Looks like a travel will be called on Williams.
Ball.
Williams took a step before he put the ball on the court. The refs have been very quick to call that on both the ladies' side of the house and the men's tonight.
Howard bringing the ball up court. Gives it to Coleman. Coleman on a drive. Get that out of here, says Kendall Gray. It is a block party, ladies and gentlemen.
It looked pretty by Coleman until he got to the point where he wanted to get rid of the ball. And that's when Gray said, we'll have none of that.
Looks like Raheem Brown will check into the game.
Hornet foul number two, Kendall Williams, his second personal team's eighth. Bonus situation, shooting 1-1.
So the Hornets are now in a bonus situation with a minute remaining here in the first half. First free throw is good by Kai Howard, the 6'3" sophomore out of Philadelphia.
Just look sometimes, Byron, that the Hornets are slow in reacting when they've taken a ball off the dribble.
Hornets lead by 6, 26-20.
1 minute.
Rakeen Brown just checked in for his first time this season.
Owens, jump shot, no good.
Out of bounds, Hornets basketball.
Looks like a turnover there. The pass just a bit outside for Damon Lynn. Walker gets the ball. Williams on the drive. Gives it to Gray. Went up for the monster jam resembling Blake Griffin. If he would have put that one in, I think I would have had to leave, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, he started off in Wilmington with that one. And
brought it back to Dover. Sheesh.
Wow.
Shooting to Kendall.
Almost Gray. Jumping over another human being.
I like the aggressiveness.
First free throw is good.
I like the aggressiveness of Gray so far in this first half. He's taking it in.
Let these little guys know they can't guard you. Barbecue chicken. Twenty seconds remaining here in the first half. Hornets up by 8. They'll stay with the trap and defense here. Damon Lynn for 3. Shot is off. Rebounded. Jump ball. Looks like it'll go to NJIT.
Well, Damon Lynn struggling from the field goal percentage this afternoon, which is actually a good thing. Good hustle by Rakeen. Just couldn't keep it inbounds.
It'll actually force them back all the way on the other side of the court. So
takes time off the clock.
Damon Lynn will bring the ball up. Three-pointer, no good.
It's halftime in the Hornets' nest.
What it is now halftime here.
Hornets,
the Hornets lead 28-20. Rolling with the first half behind us. What are some things that stand out to you so far looking at this game and this matchup?
Well, I like the way that the Hornets so far have been playing their half-court offense. They're trying to get the ball down to Kendall Gray. If he's had the shots, he's converted on the shots. If not, he's playing a little bit with Nick Doyle, who's been able to knock down some jumpers. I like the way they're doing it offensively. Defensive side of the house, They seem to be a little slow in reacting to the Highlanders as they're taking the ball to the hole. The Hornets are a bigger team than the Highlanders. And right now, though, the Highlanders seem to be outworking them on the defensive side of the boards. So for the second half, what we need to see out of the Hornets, stick with that offense. I like what they're doing there. But they need to stack it up on defense and start working them a little bit harder on the boards.
Definitely want to see Kendall Gray get the ball a little bit more. He's definitely showing a lot of good things this half. And Kendall Williams as well, playing a little two-man game with those two. And Coach Jackson's bench, will they continue to use it? And how will that affect this game with an eight-point lead? So.
Attention, ladies and gentlemen. Please support the Delaware State University.
We're going to wrap that up for now. We'll be back in a little bit. We'll show you halftime stats and all of that. With that being said, we'll be right back.
Attention, Delaware State alumni, family, and friends. We need your support. Help students stay in school by giving to the DSU Scholarship Fund. For more information, please visit our website at www.desu.edu and click on Contribute to DSU. Pride your achievements. Johnson's is a proud sponsor of the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference. Just do it. Nike is the official footwear provider of the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference. The MEAC online store provides the one-stop shopping for all MEAC school apparel and accessories. Fans can now purchase t-shirts, hoodies, pants, luggage, jackets, license plates, and so much more. All adorned with the MEAC or MEAC institutional logos. The store also carries merchandise from companies like Adidas, Nike, and Under Armour. MEAC students, fans, and alumni can buy their gear instantly and support their favorite MEAC team from anywhere in the world. For more information or order your MEAC merchandise, please visit the website www.themeacstore.com or www.meacsports.com.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for our halftime contest. If you're here for the ladies' game, we have another minute to win it game. Up first, we have Alexis. Her challenge is to stack 36 cups in a pyramid form within a minute and also take them down. You ready, Alexis? Three, two, one, start. One cup at a time, 36 cups. Seconds. Oh, 15 seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. Everybody give Alexis a round of applause for trying so hard. Up next we have Jessica. The object of this game is to keep all three balloons in the air within a minute's time frame. She can only use one hand. You ready, Jessica? Three, two, one, start. Keep them all up, keep them up. One hand, keep them up. Keep them up, keep them up. Ah. Big round of applause for Jessica one time. That one looked kind of difficult. Up next, we have the 24-second clock. You have to make a layup, a free throw, and a three-pointer. You ready, Zach? Go. I made the layup. Let's go, Zach. Shoot the free throw. 9 seconds. Three, two, good try, good try. Once again, that was brought to you by Delaware State University Athletic Department. Thank you to all our contestants. Thank you.
10, 5, and 22.
Welcome back to WDSU-TV's coverage of Hornet basketball. It is halftime here in the Hornet's Nest as your Delaware State University Hornets lead New Jersey Institute of Technology, NJIT, by a score of 28-20. We're just about set to get second half action underway here. Throughout the first half, many of things have stood out to this game, one being the emergence and play of Kendall Gray and that of Kendall Williams, the Kendall and Kendall show. Both players have pretty much put their impact on this game. Kendall Gray not only doing it offensively, but defensively as well. He's had blocks and rebounds, just as Kendall Williams knocking down open jump shots. I'm gonna bring back in Roland. Roland, what are you looking forward to in the second half here?
Well, I'm hoping the Hornets can sit there and keep that offense going the way that it was doing in the first half. That is feeding Kendall Gray down low, making the Highlanders have to collapse onto him. If he doesn't have the shot, so be it. Kick it out to somebody like Nick Doyle or Kendall Williams and have them knock it back. I like the way they played their offense. Like I said before, we closed out on that first half. What I didn't like was their defense. I thought they were getting outworked on the rebounding. And they need to step it up. They've got to put pressure on their perimeter shooting for the Highlanders because that's where they make their money. And Jake Duncan nailed three threes. The only thing that's helping them out right now is that Damon Lynn has yet to heat up in this game, and let's hope that he doesn't when he comes out here in the second half. It's very critical right now with an 8-point lead for the Hornets to start out strong, just like we covered before this game started, and to keep the pressure on the smaller Highlander team to try to wear them out here in the second half. But right now, it'll be interesting how this thing plays out, but they can't let the Highlander speed get to them, Byron.
Definitely rolling good points there. We're about ready to resume play here. Looks like KC Walker and Tyshawn Bell actually start this half, along with Nick Doyle, Kendall Williams, and Kendall Gray. So we'll see how this other lineup works out for Coach Jackson. Doyle, top of the key, out to Walker. Doyle out to Bell. Bell's shot is no good.
Out of bounds, Hornets ball.
It looks like Damon Lynn lost the ball there, actually. And we'll go back to the Hornets.
Yeah, just an unforced error there by, but then he gets it right back.
Ball is not the way.
Still Highlander ball.
Good hustle back there by Nick Doyle as they turned it over, pushed it up, and Jake Duncan trying to get the easy layup, but Doyle was back there to make the nice block.
Shot is no good there from Duncan. Pass out to Williams. Walker to Williams. Shot is blocked.
Still
by
Hornets
Tim
ball.
Coleman. A swat from behind. So.
Yeah, it was a good look by Williams. He was open when he took that shot. It was just a good hustle by Damon Lynn to get back defensively and make that block.
Pass out to Walker. Bell for three. Shot is halfway down and rims out. Looks like it'll be a jump ball situation here.
Good hustle there by Casey Walker to tie that up. Granted, the possession arrow is over to the Highlanders, but it was a good hustle to get on the floor and tie that ball up.
For number two, Tim Coleman.
Highlander basketball.
Tough luck on Tyshawn Bell's three-pointer, too. That was in and out. Rattled that rim nicely and popped right back out.
Damon Lynn has the ball. Gives it off to Terrence Smith. Looks like a
too travel
will
many
be called.
Steps, Hornets basketball.
Been a lot of traveling violations this evening on both sides.
Ball to Gray. Walker dribbling, look for someone, finds Nick Doyle. Out to Williams. Williams gives it to Gray. Pass to Walker, three-point shot is no good. Bell, the pump fake, draws the foul.
Good ball movement underneath, Byron. They got it down to Kendall Gray. Didn't have a shot. He kicked it out to Williams. Williams to Doyle. Doyle to Walker. Walker took a nice jumper. Came in and out. Bell underneath to get a nice offensive rebound. Couldn't convert, but didn't get the foul.
Bell will head to the line for two shots. Shot is good. Second free throw for Bell. Up and in. Extends the Del State lead to 10, 30 to 20, 18 minutes and 17 seconds remaining here in the second half. O'Dara with the ball back out to Howard. Howard gives the ball to Duncan.
The hoop is good by number zero,
and the
Kai
harm
Howard.
From Kai Howard. He will head to the line for a free throw to complete the old-fashioned three-point
Hornet
play.
Foul number 22, Casey Walker, his second personal, team's first.
Yeah, that was just straight-up good work by Kai Howard.
Shooting one, Kai Howard.
Got up in the air, drew the foul, and converted a tough shot.
Highlander substitution number two, Tim Coleman, for number 22, Adara Anuki.
Williams to bring the ball past half court. Bell gives it out to Gray.
I didn't see that foul, Byron.
Me
Highlander
either.
Foul number five, Damon Lynn. His second personal, team second.
Walker receives the ball on the other side of the court here. Williams gives it out to Walker. Walker to Doyle. Williams to Bell. Doyle takes the screen from Bell. Williams. Drive, no good. Good look, though, for there from Williams.
Yeah, Williams just ran out of space underneath.
Shot is blocked.
Out of bounds, still Highlander ball.
By Kendall Gray, something we've come accustomed to seeing. Get that out of here, he says to Duncan. You're not going to shoot at my house. Lynn on a drive, step back jump shot is no good. Rebounded by Gray. Williams brings the ball, pass half court. Doyle loses the basketball.
Out of bounds,
Highlander
ball.
Doyle just didn't concentrate. Didn't look the ball in, it just went right off his hands, out of bounds. Lackadaisical turnover there by the Hornets.
Duncan gets the ball on the left wing. He will shoot that, and the shot is no good. Rebounded, and he will be fouled.
Well, Duncan's had two looks at the three-point line in the second half and hasn't converted either one, which is good for the Hornets. However, again, we're still having problems with the defensive rebound side of the house.
Tyron Smith.
Shooting two, Tim Coleman.
And the Hornets are just continuously getting outworked underneath the Highlanders' basket.
Hornets substitution, number 23,
good
Jason
by Tim
Owens
Coleman.
For number
Jason
five, Tyshawn Bell.
Check in for Tyshawn Bell.
That was Tyshawn Bell's fourth foul, so he's going to have to sit for quite a while now here in the second half.
Coleman knocks down the free throws, brings the Highlanders within 5 points. Williams on a drive to Walker. Walker to Doyle. Doyle to Williams. Pass is intercepted but regained by Doyle. Doyle tries a reverse layup. Shot is blocked. 8 seconds on the shot clock.
Yeah, Jason Media Owens trying out to force that ball Hornet down fans, low. Show your love Kendall for your Gray, DSU cheerleaders. Nick Doyle picked it up as the ball went loose, but that was just a poor attempt by Owens down low. Right now, the Hornets look a little sluggish offensively. They're not playing that crisp.
It's like they don't have the same energy they had when they first came out to start the game. Now the Highlanders have come back in this game a little bit, make it closer.
On the previous possession prior to this, Nick Doyle just took his eyes off the ball and the ball sails out of bounds. Now on this one here, they still haven't produced a good shot.
15:55 remaining.
One more time for the ladies. State.
30-25, Delaware State leads NJIT.
Make sure you visit the website. Going through, you're gonna make it. God's gonna see you through. Hold your head up, put a smile on your face. This is another test. He won't miss always. So get ready for your lesson. Get ready for your minute clock. Get ready for your lesson. Get ready.
8 seconds on the shot clock. Delaware State leads 30-25. Doyle on a pull-up jumper. Shot is halfway down and rattles out.
That was tough luck by Doyle. Rolled completely around inside that rim and still bounced out of there.
Williams brings the ball past half court. Gray with the ball to Williams. Doyle with the entry pass to Owens. Ball tipped back to Williams. Ball movement looks like it was touched by Kendall Gray, and it'll be Highlanders basketball.
One too many passes there by Doyle. Doyle was open for the jumper. He should have taken that one from 15 foot.
Duncan on a drive, out to Lynn. Lynn on a fake, out to Duncan again. Good close out there by Walker. Coleman's three-pointer is short.
Yeah, so far so good for the Hornets when dealing with Lynn and Duncan. They haven't started to hit their marks here in the second half, which has played into the Hornets' hands. However, only a 5-point lead here with 15 minutes left.
Williams will try to set up some type of offense here. Williams, Walker fumbles the pass. Owens will shoot that.
Jason
jump shot is good
Owens
from about 18 feet.
That was a smooth shot by Owens right there at the top of the key. They knocked down their first field goal in over 3 minutes.
Duncan, three-point shot straight on. He's a three-point marksman, ladies and gentlemen, and he hits the three there.
Not what the Hornets want to see is Jake Duncan start to fire that ball up.
Not what Coach Jackson wants to see. They call the timeout immediately. Score is 32-28. 14-17 remaining in the second half.
Yeah, Jake Duncan's a 6'4" freshman out of Williamsburg, Virginia, and he is giving them quality minutes here. That's his fourth three-pointer of the game.
Come on.
got a total of 12 points to show for it. Like I said earlier, this is a very young team that the Highlanders got here in this Division III, and they're playing very good basketball against the Hornets this evening.
...14-17 remaining, 32-28 here in the second half.
Big disparity between the three-point shots, too. They're 4 of 19 for the game, and we're 1 for 5, the Hornets are shooting from the three-point marker.
Hornets struggles from behind the arc continue.
And Jake Duncan is lighting them up.
Doyle receives the pass from Williams. Williams running around the baseline, gets the ball back. Owens will shoot that jump shot he likes. Shot
Jason
is good.
Owens.
He's about 3 for 3 from the field, ladies and gentlemen. Jason Owens with that smooth-looking jump shot, as Roland said.
He's getting open, and he's knocking it down. It's looking very sweet from that 15 to 18-foot range right now for Owens. That's good quality time coming off the bench for the Hornets. Nice steal.
Stolen by Owens. Owens. Shot is blocked. Hard foul there, making sure that Owens can't finish that layup.
Good work by Owens. Coleman had to commit that foul because Owens was going to bring down the house with that one. But he looks okay, and he's up, and he's ready to shoot his two. Our cameraman, Portland, he had to get out of the way, otherwise he was going to be part of the carnage as well.
Owens wearing number 23, tried to jump in the free throw line like Jordan. Second free throw is no good. It doesn't make either. Like a foul be called on Doyle.
Corner foul number 10, Nick Doyle, his first personal, team's third.
Trapping defense there. We have a stoppage in play here.
Yeah, I think we got a shot clock problem is what we've got.
A little clock malfunction there. The officials conjugate to get that together. 13-28 remaining. Delaware State leads 34-28. Duncan. Duncan to shot is no good there, actually, by Lynn off the screen.
Out of bounds, Highlander ball.
Just a case of misfortune right there. Jason Lawson gets the rebound, just can't hang on to it, steps out of bounds trying to get the pass over to Nick Doyle.
Shot is blocked, looks like, there by Williams. Gray, I mean, sorry. Walker gives the ball to Kendall. Kendall to Casey Walker, out to Owens. Owens getting big minutes here today. He's definitely making the most of it with Tyshawn Bell. Foul trouble.
Hornet foul number two, Kendall Williams, his third personal.
Now, Williams got the ball stripped and then trying to recover. He made the foul against him. Charles Burley going to check in for the first time here in the second half.
Substitution, number 55, Charles Burley.
We have yet to see Gosevich come in after starting and giving strong minutes here early on in the first half.
Duncan get the ball. Duncan gives it to, that is Damon Lynn. Lynn on the drive with the crossover. Duncan, pass, one more pass. Shot is no good, rebounded. Burley brings it out. Burley to Doyle. Gray with the jump hook. Shot is no good.
That play worked well in the first half, getting Gray and Doyle working down low and then getting the outside shots when Gray couldn't convert below.
Pass to O'Dara. Howard looking for someone. Damon Lynn comes up. Reverse, no good, but he is fouled by Owens.
Kai Howard just found himself free down low, and Lawson just committed a foul. There's no way that guy should be left all alone inside that paint. And a call timeout by the Hornets. Regroup after that fiasco.
See, Delaware State offense not really creating a lot of opportunities this half as it did in the first half. So, be interesting to see how that plays out through the rest of this game. Just like
for more information on ESPNU, call your local cable operator,
Jordan Lawson, check in soon.
Or log on to the website, www.espnu.com.
Krogan on the field of play. Russell Athletics is
11:30 remaining here in the second half. The Hornets lead 34-28. Roland, what do you think about this half so far?
I think offensively they just haven't gotten their game going. They look very sluggish. Not the crispness that we saw in the first half. And what they needed to correct, they still haven't done it. They're still getting outworked on the defensive side of the floor. And right now, what I'm listening is listen to this crowd. You'd never know this was a home game because it's like quiet as church here. And the Hornets have a lead by 6, but you'd never know about a crowd because they're just quiet as a church here.
We're about ready to resume play here. Let's look at some of the stats here. Kendall Gray with 9 points. Kendall Williams.
Eagles keychain on it. Please report to the scores table. Thank you. Shooting 2, Kai Howard.
Right now, the only thing saving the Hornets' bacon, right, is the Highlanders are only shooting 23% from the field, while the Hornets are shooting 39.
Kai Howard makes the free throw. Burley into the game here, running the point guard for the Hornets. Pass is thrown away out of the reach of Kendall Gray.
Another turnover, something they've got to correct if they're going to put the W up this evening. So Highlanders are not going to go away here, Byron.
Looks like a travel will be called.
Hornets basketball.
They're trying to rack up points on Expedia. Burley. Burley gives the ball to Gray, back to Burley. Doyle gives it back to Burley, who gives it to Walker. Gray is in the post. Calling for the ball, so is Lawson.
Burley. Another travel.
Highlander ball.
Right now, Gray is getting worked over by Terrence Smith, and Smith is doing a wonderful job of keeping Gray from the ball. The Hornets have got to try to figure out how to free him open, where they need to pick, do some picks down low to get Gray to open up to get the passing lane back going. Right now, the Hornets are moving along the perimeter, but they have no shots doing it.
Pass to DeMond Lynn, out to Duncan. Lynn shoots the three, shot is no good. Looks like it'll be Del State ball.
Out of bounds, Hornets ball.
Williams will bring the ball up for Del State. Williams gives it to Bell. Bell checks back in with his four fouls, 10 minutes remaining here. Hornets up by four.
Yeah, Tyshawn Bell just trying to force it down low. And Lawson just couldn't get the handle of it. Turned the ball over, back over to the Highlanders. So far, it's been an uneventful second half here, Byron.
Fake there, gives it out to Duncan for three. Shot is off, but it's rebounded there by Howard. DeMond Lynn on the drive.
Well, the Hornets are letting the Highlanders stay, hang around, and they're making good use of their time with them.
His first personal team six.
The Highlanders look to be faster, quicker to the hoop, and getting the best opportunities.
Howard will set up the Highlander offense.
He's gone. Tyshawn Bell just fouled out.
Hornet foul number five, Tyshawn Bell. That's his fifth personal, team seventh.
Wow.
Looks like Tyshawn Bell is now disqualified, has five personal fouls. So that's going to be a big impact as this game plays out.
Well, Bell goes out with 2 points, or two rebounds, I should say.
Shooting one and one, Jake Duncan.
Duncan to the line, makes the first. Duncan to the line for the second free throw. Makes both. NJIT draws to within 2 points. Delaware State University is going through a little scoring drought here, so see if they can get some points on the board here. About 9 minutes remaining here in this game. Williams to Doyle. Doyle to Walker. Walker will shoot the three. Shot is good.
That was a big answer for Casey Walker to knock down three, because it's been very quiet in this house.
One thing about Casey Walker, he can get hot quickly, and they may need him here to knock down those three-point shots and draw the defense out so he can drive and open up some driving lanes for others. Shot is off. Doyle with the rebound.
And that's what's saving the Hornets right now, is that the Highlanders just can't knock down their shots, because they've been open to take them. They just haven't converted their field goals.
Williams will look for someone. He gives it to Walker. Walker comes off that screen. Doesn't like what he sees, so he gives it back. Walker shot is no good. Rebounded by Gray. Up and in. Be important to get him going. He's going to have to get some shots here in the second half.
Yeah, that was a good follow-up by Gray. Get that rebound, put it right back in for an easy two. Stretch that lead back out to seven. Give the Hornets a little bit of breathing room.
Shot is blocked, but a foul is called.
I don't know about that one, Byron. It looked pretty clean there by Lawson.
Looks like it'll be a timeout on the floor. The Hornets lead in JIT 39-32 with 7 minutes and 49 seconds remaining here in the game.
Bay Health Medical Center, Kent General, and Milford Memorial Hospitals. Care for people living in central and southern Delaware. Learn more about Bay Health by visiting the website www.bayhealth.org.
This has not been the second half that Coach Jackson has envisioned for his Hornets, I would imagine.
University Athletics.
With Bell on the bench, done for the evening with 5 fouls and only contributing 2 points. Big disappointment for him today.
The Delaware State University offense needs to get going in a hurry.
Well, the band's trying to get this crowd in gear. We'll see how it works.
No time like the present. We're about ready to resume play here.
Shooting 2, Damon Lynn.
Shot is good by Damon Lynn. Second free throw is good as well. Williams will bring the ball up court for the Hornets. Doyle receives the ball top of the key, gives it off to Casey Walker. Williams, the pick from Lawson. Crossover.
Out of bounds, Highlander ball.
Poor anticipation of Williams with Doyle there. He tried to get the ball down to Lawson, but Lawson was not open to even get them. That whole series on offense was, I don't know how to explain it. It just wasn't there trying to make something out of nothing.
Highlander foul number 22, Odera Anuki, his third personal, team's fourth.
It will be Del State ball, 7 minutes remaining. Del State leads 39-34. Williams gives it off to Walker. Walker to Doyle. Lawson looks like he wants the ball in the post. He doesn't get it. That's like a double dribble was called.
Highlander ball.
Kendall Williams just have a bad couple of series now. Throws the ball away at Doyle. Now gets a charge with a double dribble.
Zero, Rakeem Brown for number 2.
Looks
Kendall
like Rakeem Bell will check in for Williams.
I think Brown, Williams just needs to sit down and get his head straightened out. Seems out of sorts.
Still there by Gray. Brown gives it off to Doyle. Walker back to Brown, gives it to Doyle. Brown on a drive out to Doyle. Doyle with the pull up. Shot is no good. Rebound out to NJIT's Kai Howard. Ball is deflected from Doyle. Doyle dribbles
draws the foul going coast to coast.
Just a little concerned with Doyle bringing that ball up. He didn't have the numbers going up against the Highlanders, but he drove to the basket and got the foul.
Shooting to Nick Dole.
First free throw is no good for Doyle.
Yeah, right now we're shooting 9 for 15 from the free throw line.
Second free throw is in for Doyle off the back of the glass.
Hasn't been a smooth night on the line there, Byron.
Guess the bank is open on a Monday night. Duncan to Len. Len gives it back to Duncan. Duncan on a drive. Stop there. Met by Lawson. Shot from Len is no good. And it'll be no basket. It'll be a call on the floor on Kendall Gray.
Hornet foul number one, push. Kendall Gray. His second personal, team's ninth.
Ninth team foul for Delaware State. So they're in a bonus.
Yeah, Kendall Gray just cleared out everybody underneath trying to get that rebound. He got flagged with the foul.
Free throw is good for Howard.
One more free throw for Kai Howard.
This is what's been keeping the Highlanders into the game here in the second half. They're 12 of 14 from the free throw line. Make that 12 of 15. That's where they're getting their points.
Looks like Jason Owens will check back in. He's giving them good quality minutes off the bench so far.
Two ill-advised passes and now
pass
a foul.
Pass is stolen, and looks like it'll be a foul on Brown.
Brown made an ill-advised pass to Lawson, and then Lawson returned the favor, turned the ball over, and then Rakeem Brown had to foul him to keep him from getting the easy layup. And now Damon Lynn will go to the line shooting two.
Double bonus, shooting two.
Damon Lynn will head to the line for two free throws. First free throw is no good.
Morning substitution, number 23, Jason Owens.
Lawson will come in for Jason.
Lawson
will come in for Jason Owens. Owens, like I said, giving quality minutes off the bench. Free throw, second free throw is good by Damon Lynn. Brown, jab step. Dribbles inside. Walker to Doyle. Owens, pump fake, posts up. Brown gives it right back to Owens. Owens out to Walker. Three-pointer is short off the front rim. It will stay here. Looks like a foul was called.
Highlander foul number 5.
Good luck by Walker. Couldn't knock it down, but Rakeem Brown went right after a rebound, got rewarded by picking up a foul.
Brown receives the inbound pass from Doyle.
Timeout, Delaware State.
Coach Jackson is livid over there on the sideline.
30-second timeout.
That's because they played a little over 15 minutes here in the second half and have done nothing offensively to even put this game out of reach. They've lost Tyshawn Bell to the foul. But offensively, they've been non-existent here in the second half.
Only 12 points in the second half.
And the Highlanders, the only reason they can't gain ground is they can't hit their field goals. But the Hornets allow them to stay in because they're putting them on the free throw line. They are knocking down their free throws. So the position that the Hornets are in, they only have to blame themselves for their predicament right now.
Hornets ball, 4 minutes, 30 seconds remaining, up by 4. Here on WDSU-TV's continuing coverage of Hornet basketball. Once again, my name is Byron Dixon, joined alongside Roland DeVries. Doyle gives it into Gray. Brown thought about shooting it there, takes it back. Walker draws the block. He will hit the line for two free throws.
Walker got a quick step. Was able to get the ball down low and take the jumper and draw the foul. But earlier on, they got the ball down to Kendall Gray, kicked it out to Rakeem Brown. Brown was open for the jumper. I don't know why he didn't take it.
Walker misses his first free throw. Second free throw is good for Walker. Lynn. Duncan orchestrated where he wants his teammates to go. Doyle with the steal. Great hustle there by Nick Doyle. Gives it to Owens. Lays it in. Jason Owens has earned himself some playtime tonight. Coach Jackson should definitely be taking note and seeing what he has.
You got that right, Byron. Nick Doyle, though, good hustle on there. Get the turnover. Keep the ball inbounds. Not get charged with a travel. Get it on over to get the play set up so Owens could convert the easy two.
Definitely great hustle play there by Nick Doyle, diving out for the good of his team and creating an easy layup for Jason Owens, which he finished very strong. So it is 43-36 here at Memorial Hall Gym. 3:24 remaining here in the second half. Second game of a doubleheader. Lady Hornets won earlier today. So see if the men can hold on and get a win here. Offensive struggles have been a problem, but hopefully they can overcome that and get this win. How sets up the offense. Dell stayed in a little bit of a zone here, it seems like. Trap the corner, and the ball is retrieved easily by Terrence Smith with the easy cleanup layup.
Yeah, Smith was just unopposed in the paint, went up hard, got the offensive rebound, went right back up with it for the easy two. And the Hornets have struggled against rebounding the ball. Kendall Gray was hoping to bring the house down with that one.
Highlander foul number 15, Terrence Smith. His third personal, team's eighth. Media timeout.
Cross Blue Shield, Delaware is the official health insurance sponsor for DSU Athletics.
Hornets lead 43-38. 2:46 remaining here in the second half. Roland, what it is this team have to do down the stretch to close out this game and get a win?
Sound. They got to play sound offensively. They haven't done anything offensively to write home about. Another thing, defensively, they're just getting outworked. And right now, like I said this about 5 minutes, I mean, it's been this way throughout this whole second half. Delaware State is not doing anything offensively, and defensively they're getting outworked. And 5 points is nothing in this game with 2 minutes and 46 seconds left. Another thing that doesn't help them is that they're at home, and you would never even know it because there's nothing going on inside of Memorial Hall. I find it mind-boggling, actually, that you've got a home game and it's quiet. So quiet in here, you'd never know it, that you're playing basketball.
.246 remaining. This is what we call a crunch game, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, right now, Delaware State shooting 42% from the field. with the Highlanders shooting 21. However, free throw lines are sitting 79% to Delaware State 61%.
Kendall Gray has a double-double, 11 points, 10 rebounds. Let's see if he can add to that point total here at the line for two free throws that he has. First free throw is good. So that'll make 12 points, 10 rebounds for Kendall Gray. Recently named MEAC Player of the Week. Honored before the game in a quick ceremony. Second free throw is no good, so he'll stay at 12 points, 10 rebounds.
Yeah, they recognize Kendall Gray and Casey Walker.
Pass to Terrence.
Terrence Smith. Timeout, NJIT.
Shot is good.
Too easy of a basket down there.
30-second timeout.
.235 remaining. The Hornets lead 44-40. Here in the waning moments of the second half. Owens inbound to Doyle. Doyle is fouled there.
Yeah, DeMond Lynn just got over aggressive. I'm not sure whether they
Highlanders
need to put this much pressure on them with 2.5 minutes left to go in this game. No reason to put the Hornets on the line. They've struggled offensively to knock down the field goal percentage.
Doyle's free throw is good.
Wow.
That will send the lead to 5 with 2:30 remaining in the second half.
One more free throw for Nick Doyle.
Shot is good again from Doyle. Makes both free throws.
Well, it looks like the Hornets gave up on that full court press after they were able to bust it and get that easy two.
Duncan loses the ball. Gray with the steal. Brown will bring it up court for the Hornets. He is
traveling violation, Highlander ball.
Fouled. If not, DeMond Lynn would have had an easy clear layup to the basket.
Yeah, Rakeem Brown just dribbled himself out of control into the front court, left himself no outlet.
Lynn, pull up, jump shots, no good from DeMond Lynn. Rebounded, no good, another rebound. Shot is blocked, another rebound. Looks like it'll be
jump ball possession. Jump ball.
Hornet basketball.
You know, Jason Owens originally came out of there with the first rebound, but he just didn't secure it. The Highlanders got it out of there, took two more shots before they were able to get a jump ball.
Kendall Williams checked back into the game. He has the ball. Gives it to Walker. Walker back to Williams. Williams on the drive. Looks like a foul call.
Number 0, Kai Howard. His second personal, team's 10th.
Williams will double Walker bonus. Will hit to the line for two free throws.
Walker.
First free throw is no good.
shot is good. Hornets lead by 7 with 1 minute 25 seconds remaining here in the second half. Pull-up jump shot is good from
Tim Coleman. Timeout,
and it'll
NJIT.
Be a timeout by NJIT.
Yeah, Coleman had a good look at the jumper.
Full
timeout. Good look at the basket, knocked down that 15-foot jumper to pull him within 5. Right now, again, look, this is how quiet it is inside of Memorial Hall. Now as the band kicks in.
It'll now be all about how you close out games and can the Hornets close this game out and get a win at home.
Well, minute 15 left. I have a feeling the Highlanders are now going to put full court pressure on the Hornets to try to get the ball back out of them. We'll see how it plays out.
One minute, 15 seconds remaining. Hornets lead 47-42. Hopefully, Coach Jackson is telling his team, you got to close out games. You're up by 5. The game isn't over yet. If you play smart, you can win this game. So let's see what these Hornets do.
Well, if they get the win, that's all they get out of this game is the win. Because they started off the first 5 minutes of this game working the ball down low to Kendall Gray and getting Nick Doyle working the offense with them. They started off on the right foot. After that, it's just been going downhill offensively throughout the rest of the evening.
Pass is inbounded to Williams. Williams to Walker. Doyle out to Owens. The second foul was called.
Highlander foul number 0, Kai Howard. His third personal, team's 10.
Well, they must have gotten Howard fouling Doyle then as he was trying to release the ball.
Nick Doyle.
Nick Doyle will shoot too. First free throw is good. Second free throw is no good.
One minute.
3-pointer is good. Kai Howard, looks like a travel should have been called.
Kai Howard.
Cuts the Hornet lead to 3. Doyle loses the ball.
Hornets getting sloppy here.
3-pointer is up and off. By Damon Lynn.
Lynn rushed that shot with 40 seconds left. There's really no reason to take that 3 right then. He could have worked it a little bit longer.
Highlander foul.
Try to get a better shot.
His second personal, team's 10th. Double bonus. Shooting to Nick Dole.
Dole's free throw is good. Now we'll extend the Hornet lead to 4 points with 40 seconds remaining.
That's a key to possession. If you can knock this one down.
Second free throw is no,
no good.
Foul is called. And they will get a chance to get free throws with the clock stop. 2 free throws.
Cut it down to within 2, make it a one-possession ball game. Like you say, Byron, take no time off the clock.
Shoot it to Kai Howard.
Howard to the line.
He's been 6-7 from the stripe already this evening. 7-8.
Hornets
No.
Free throw is good. Cuts the lead to three with 33 seconds remaining. Looks like Odera will check into the game. But it's rebounded. Duncan for three. Three-pointer is good. And we are tied with 29 seconds remaining. Of all things to give up, an offensive rebound on a free throw, and then allowing their best three-point shooter to get a wide open look for three to tie up the game. That's just Del State basketball, I guess.
Full timeout.
You were just kind of waiting for it to happen. It seemed like the whole crowd was waiting for this to happen, that the whole collapse were to end right here close at the end. But the Hornets have let the Highlanders hang around all evening, and sure enough, they just waited and waited and knocked down the shots when they needed to.
Finishing off games. I talked about it before this sequence, and they couldn't finish it off. You have to think, what is Coach Jackson telling his team? They haven't been able to close this game. Is this team losing confidence? And is the momentum swinging to NJIT?
40 minutes is what you have to play on a basketball court. And right now, the Hornets have played about 36, and then that was it. I would like to tell you that the crowd is stunned, but you'd never know it because they weren't like cheering to begin with throughout the evening. But the players for the Hornets look stunned.
There's still plenty of time for Del State to win this game, but you have to hope that someone can take over. Who's cold-blooded? Who has the killer instinct? Who can put the kids to bed and get us out of here with a win?
Yeah, shot clock is turned off with 29.9 seconds.
You got to hope for the last shot here.
Oh, yeah. What you have to do is make sure you can maintain possession getting up into the front court and not lose the ball. They've struggled the past two possessions just getting the ball up the court.
And NJIT will pressure and try to force a turnover, something they've been able to do in the last minute or so. Here comes a trap. They're going to force the action, NJIT, and see if Delaware State can handle it. Gray shot is blocked. 15 seconds remaining.
And he is down.
He is hurt. Three-pointer for Lynn. Shot is no good. He is fouled.
Travel
is called. We have a player down. Kendall Gray is down. We have a traveling call. It is a lot going on right now in Memorial Hall. The crowd has awoken. You can hear the impact from the hardwood floor. Ladies and gentlemen, this isn't a mattress.
Kendall Gray's in a lot of pain on the ground. I'm still unsure what is, whether it's a hip or whether it's his right shoulder. But setting the game right now, we have 7 seconds left. They're still seeing the Kendall Gray here underneath the Hornet basketball.
They're going to have to get somebody in here quick.
With 7 seconds left, Hornets will have the ball. It'll be a quick to get the ball up court and get that final shot. They're going to try to bring Kendall Gray up to the sitting position, which they have.
Looks like he's going to walk off the court. Always a good sign when they walk off the court. May have just been a hard impact. Looks like they're going
to
go small here. They're going to go with a small lineup. 7 seconds left. It will be Hornet basketball. You got to be looking at Casey Walker looking to take the shot here. He can shoot from outside, so if he's forced into a tough position, he's very comfortable shooting from 25 feet.
If you're not finding Walker, you're going for the man trying to inbound the ball, and that's Doyle.
Doyle called a timeout, try to draw up something here. NJIT is not backing off the pressure. They're forcing the action here. And Delaware State, they're folding under it a little bit.
remix, remix, whack, juvenile, skip.
Yeah, the Hornets didn't expect this to happen in their own house this evening. But that nightmare is playing over again. Greg gonna check back in now.
Kendall Gray has checked back into the game. That's a good sign, so looks like he's all right.
Uh-oh. That's what I wasn't sure about, because the ball never was inbounded. So there was never a start of the clock to allow Gray to come back in. So
right.
They had to go back to the original lineup.
Williams to Doyle. Owens will shoot it for the win. Shot is off the rim, and we are headed to overtime.
NJIT 49.
They're locked at 49. Well, Roland, buckle your seatbelt or unbuckle it. We're here for another 5 minutes.
Yeah, it looks that way. The Hornets have allowed the Highlanders to get right back into this game, and sure enough, they're making the best use of it.
Well, Roland, we get free basketball here at Memorial Hall Gym tonight. With overtime, we're deadlocked at 49. What are some things you're looking forward to that the coaches may be telling their team? 5 minutes on the clock. Whoever scores the most points in this period wins.
Yeah. And right now, the Hornets are just having trouble getting the ball into the front court. So this may not be what the – I tell you right now, the Hornets did not want to go into overtime against this Highlander team, because the Highlanders are playing with a lot more vigor. And the Hornets are just struggling to
Hornet
stay
fans,
on the court right now.
Synchronize your watches and cell phones. It's time for OT.
It is overtime here at Memorial Hall Gym.
This crowd.
Ball goes to NJIT.
Seconds and they're going to the free throw line already as Lawson commits an early foul.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, you're not going home at the moment. You're here in overtime. Yes, overtime here on WDSU-TV. 4:47 remaining. NJIT to the line for two shots.
Tim Coleman.
First free throw is good for Mr. Tim Coleman. Second free throw is on the way, and it is good for Coleman. Gives NJIT a two-point lead with 4 minutes, 45 seconds remaining. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, overtime here. Let's see how these teams react.
Right now, the Highlanders are being led by that freshman, Jake Duncan, with 17 points, and Kai Howard has dumped in an additional 12. The Hornets, on the other hand, are being led by Kendall Gray with 12.
Out of bounds, Highlander ball.
And Nick Doyle with 10 as the Hornets just turn the ball over.
Looks like Howard will bring the ball up. Gives it to Coleman. Out to Lynn. Screen and roll action to perfection there between Damon Lynn and Terrence Smith. A good two-man game there. Worked to perfection. Smith with a hard screen, and when the defense collapsed, he just gave it off to him for the easy lay-in.
Yeah, Gray was caught out of position. By the time he realized what was going on, it was too late. Smith was already in the hole.
Gray will draw a foul. He's commanding for the ball. They should definitely give it to him. Try to see if he can get to the line.
Kind of wonder how much Kendall Gray is in after taking that hard fall late in the
That's his fifth personal
second
team's
half.
Death.
We're going to see how this thing goes as he's going to take his two free throws.
Pain tolerance, ladies and gentlemen. You want your great players on the floor at all costs, and you got to see. Great players play through injuries, so we'll see what Kendall Gray can do as he's hurt.
Shooting two, Kendall Gray.
Gray to the line for two free throws. First free throw is no good. Second free throw is no good as well, and he fouls. Howard trying to get the offensive rebound.
Point of foul number one, Kendall Gray. That's his fourth personal, team's 10th.
The wheels are just coming off the train here in the overtime, too. They're trailing by four, and now they're going to be letting the Highlanders take another two,
double
three ones.
Shooting two, Kai Howard.
Howard will go to the line for two. And if Delaware State loses this game, you can rack this up as an all-time worst collapse.
I'd go along with that.
They've given this game away, and it has been hard to watch. Second free throw is no good. Rebounded by Gray. Williams. Doyle takes the pass from Owens. Williams on the drive. Dumps it off to Gray. Layup
Kendall
is good.
Gray.
3 minutes remaining here. Howard on the drive. Gives it off to Duncan.
Both teams are putting good pressure and kicking them out to the outside. Now it's just going to come down to who can convert their shots.
Howard on a drive, loses the ball,
bounce,
off his leg. Hornet
basketball,
ladies and gentlemen.
That was a big turnover right there. Gets the Hornets to the basketball back, trailing by three with 2:40 left.
2 minutes, 41 seconds remaining. Hornets trail by three.
Highlander foul number zero, Kai Howard. That's his fourth personal, team's 10th.
It's a foul away from the ball.
Double Looks like bonus. Casey Walker will head to the
Shooting
line.
Shooting two, Casey.
You got to wonder if missing some of these free throws won't come back to hurt the Hornets. They missed some early on.
Yeah, they're shooting 17 for 28 for a 61% clip.
So if you think you make maybe three or four more of those, you're in the lead of this game. You're winning. You're not in overtime right now.
You should never talk to my wife when it comes to free throws. She believes that that's the easiest shot. It's uncontested. Why they miss them is beyond her. So.
Pass is gathered in by Smith.
Well, they had Jake Duncan open. They didn't get it to him in time before the Hornets recovered. Otherwise, he could have broke their backs with a three.
The layup actually draws the foul. Damon Lynn went up, but tried to reverse it. He actually drew the foul.
Yeah, I think they're going to get – did they get Jason?
Foul number 23, Jason Owens.
Jason Owens on
personal, team's 10th. Shooting two, Damon Lynn.
Damon Lynn's only had 7 points this evening. He's just – he's been quiet throughout, but he's – gets himself to the line, put the points up. That's all that'll matter here late in the game.
Lim makes the first free throw and makes the second. Gives NJIT a three-point advantage of 2 minutes. 2 minutes remaining here in overtime. The extra frame. Williams with the ball, takes the pick from Owens, goes right. Walker. Walker gives it back to Williams. Williams on a drive. Looking for Walker. Gray's in the post. Walker on a drive. The layup, the wraparound. Draws the foul, gets the line, almost could cut this deficit down with these two free throws.
Highlander found number well,
that possession was all Casey Walker right there as he took the ball from the top of the key, drove the lane, and was able to get
in
the
tough
foul.
Situations, it's good to see who can create that one shot. Walker. So let's see if Delaware State can win this game. First free throw is good for Casey Walker. Walker's free throw is good, and he cuts the lead to one with 1 minute 44 seconds remaining. Duncan, Lynn. Lynn on a drive on Walker, drives by him, out to Duncan. Howard's three is no good, but it's rebounded up and in by Terrence Smith. All those big 6'8", 6'9", 6'10" guys down there, and they let Terrence Smith, 6'6", come in and get a rebound.
Well, the Hornets have been outworked all night on their defensive boards, and again, another one for the Highlanders, and they were able to convert the two and a miss.
Pull-up jumpers off by Casey Walker. The Hornets don't have to foul yet, but they have to get a stop here.
Yeah, the Highlanders are content keeping the ball on the perimeter. Work the clock.
Lynn will shoot the three. Ladies and gentlemen, that might be the dagger. Well, we highlighted him earlier in the game, impact player. Didn't have the best game, but he just kept shooting. Just keep shooting. He did. And when the time mattered most, he showed up. Get to the free throw line, making the outside jumper. And that right there, ladies and gentlemen, might have been the dagger to put Delaware State University in their proverbial coffin.
Wow.
Full timeout.
19.3 seconds left, and Damon Lynn, who's been quiet like Byron said all night long, just nails the three. And that, well, I would say quiet the crowd, but the crowd's been quiet all night to begin with. So
say that again.
But I can tell you this, what's left of the crowd is leaving.
Well, Roland, they always say, or what I always say, great players will get you eventually. They're like death and taxes. They'll get you eventually, one way or the other.
Yes, you're absolutely right on those two accounts as well. Well, the Highlanders came in there and just played their brand of basketball. They just stayed persistent. They were like bulldogs on a bone. They just wouldn't let loose. They wouldn't go away.
Ladies and gentlemen, we want to thank you for watching today's contest between Delaware State University and NJIT. Please join us for our next telecast coming up very soon. We will have MEAC action for you. For Roland DeVries, I'm Byron Dixon. Have a great night, everybody. Walker takes the ball. We'll drive up court. He'll probably shoot a jumper here. He'll go inside, makes the layup.
Walker.
They probably have to foul here to extend the game. Duncan draws the foul.
Hornet foul number 23, Jason Owens. That's his fourth personal team's 10th. Double bonus, shooting two, Jake Duncan.
First free throw's good from Duncan. Second free throw is good.
Highlander substitution number 11. Winfield.
Ladies and gentlemen, that will end our coverage here for us here at WDSU-TV. For Roland DeVries, I am Byron Dixon. Delaware State University falls yet again. Everybody have a great night. Thank you.
Kendall Williams.